So Amish said something very interesting to me while he's got a soft demeanor, but he said that, you know, there is this, while I tell the story, there is a philosophy and there is something cool. You want to talk more about it? Every book has a sense, has some thought behind it. You want to talk a little bit more about that?
Yeah, all my books, they begin as pure philosophy theses. So there's some core philosophy that I want to convey. And for me, the books are the story is a wrapper around that philosophy, because pure philosophy can be a little dry, but a story can hopefully be engaging. And while reading that story, you can imbibe some of those philosophies. So the core philosophy at the heart of the Shiva trilogy, my first set of books, which was Immortals of Melua, Secret of the Nagas, and Oath of the Vayuputras. The core philosophy at the heart of the Shiva trilogy was an answer to this question: what is evil? And the core philosophy at the heart of my current series, the Ramchandra series, which is of which two books have come out till now, Sign of Ikshvaku and Sita Warrior of Mithila. The core philosophy at the heart of this series is an answer to this question: what is an ideal society? The answers aren't simple, obviously. You know, so I try and discuss issues around this through the wrapper of the story. So you can enjoy the story, but hopefully while reading it, you can think about some of the issues and philosophies I raise. And since this is at the core of what I do, I obviously aim to write non-fiction books as well. So in fact, I have a non-fiction book coming out on August 21st. It's called Immortal India.
Yes.
And those are my thoughts and musings on social issues, philosophical issues around India. So women's rights, freedom of expression, LGBT rights. That will be out on August 21st.
Very nice.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how you plug a book.